Hey guys, it's OffByOne here, and today we're going to be solving coin change. In this problem, we're given an array called coins, and this represents coins of different denominations, and they give us an integer amount that represents the total amount of money we want to get. And in this problem, they want us to return the fewest number of coins that you need to make up that amount. So for example here, we're given an amount of 11, and the coins we have to work with are 1, 2, and 5. And the solution would be to have 2 5 coins and 1 1 coin. And if the amount can't be made up with any combination of coins, then we just return negative one, like we see here. We have a coin of 2 and an amount of 3, and there's no way to get to that, so we just return negative one. Since this is a dynamic programming problem, what we want to do is take our current problem and break it up into a subset of problems. So for example, to get the least amount of coins for the amount equal to 11, we need to know the minimum amount for the ones previous. So for example, let's say we do 11 minus 5. Well, now we need to know the minimum amount of coins we need to get to 6. And so we know that 5 and 1 give us that. And now our new subproblem is going to be, what's the minimum amount of coins we need to get to 1? Well, we know that's 1. But we can see here that we're trying to solve for 11, 6, and 1. So how can we use this to develop our code? So here I've redrawn the example from the problem, and I've just made an array. And the array at the 11th index is going to be 3 because that's the minimum amount of coins we need. And for index 6, the minimum is 2. And for index 1, it's 1 because we can just make it from the 1 coin. And also, our base case is going to be 0 because we don't need any coins to have a 0 amount. So before trying to solve this using some kind of complicated algorithm, let's just do it by hand and see if we can notice any patterns. So let's see. What's the minimum amount of coins we need to get 2? Well, we know there's a coin for 2, so we can just write that down as 1 coin. And for 3, well, there's no 3 coin, but we know from doing our math that 2 and 1 are going to make up 3, and that's the least amount of coins we need, because if we do 1, 1, and 1, then that would be too many coins. That is supposed to be a 2, it's my bad. And then for 4, we know that 2 and 2 are the minimum amount of coins we need for that. So I'm just going to write that down. And then for 5, well, there's a 5 coin, so we can just put 1. 6 is already solved. And then for 7, we know there's a 5 and a 2 coin, so the minimum would be 2. For 8, we have 5, 2, and 1, and that would be the minimum amount for 8. And then for 9, we could do 5. And then 2 2 coins. So that would be 5 plus 2 plus 2, which would be 9. So that's 3 coins. And then for 10, we can use 2 fives. So we only need 2 coins for 10. So what do we see here? Well, here I'm just going to name the array to make the example easier to explain. And also, I want to address the fact that these indexes of the array are actually the amounts. And so if we're accessing index 3, for example, we're looking for the minimum amount of coins that make up 3. So whenever you access result of 3, we know we're going to get the smallest amount of coins possible to make that index. So now that we established that, what else do we know? Well, we know we want to check every single coin to see if it fits in the index. But as you can see, for 1, for example, we don't need to check 2 or 5. So we want to iterate through every coin. And for each coin, we want to check if the current index, let's just call it A, minus our current coin value is greater than or equal to 0, then we know that's a valid coin. Because, for example, let's say we are at index 1, so 1 minus 1 would give us 0, but 1 minus 2 would give us a negative 1, and that wouldn't be a valid answer. So, what do we want to do if we do find a valid coin? Well, we know if you find a valid coin, we definitely want to update our index. So we can do the result of A would be equal to the minimum amount of coins we need. And let's say we're just doing it for the first index. The way to represent that would be result of A minus coin plus 1. And the reason we do this is because result that A minus coin would be 0 because 1 minus 1 would be 0. And then we have this result here, 0. And then we want to add 1 because this represents the new coin we just iterated through right here. So while this solution does work for 1, we want to generalize it a little because we're not guaranteed that this is sorted. So for example, let's say R1 was last. Well, then our result at A would equal to result of A minus 1 plus 1, and that might not give us our min. What we actually want is the min between the result at A minus every coin. So let's say our A is equal to 11. What we want is the min between these next three values. The result at 11 minus 1, result at 11 minus 2, and result at 11 minus 5. So how do we read this? Well, let's see, result at 11 minus 1, that would be 10. And we can see that this is currently 2. So let me just write that down here. And then for 11 minus 2, that would be 9. And this gives us a value of 3. And then for 11 minus 5, we have 11 minus 5, that is 6. So our min here would be 2. And then once we find our min, what we want to do is add 1 to that, because this is what our newest coin is. So for example here, if we're doing 11 minus 1, we're looking at 10. And at this point, we have a coin of 5 and a coin of 5 making it up. And we want to add 1 to consider our coin of 1. So now we can finish our pseudocode. To start, we want to iterate through every amount. So for every amount, we want to do this loop. And then we want to check every coin. And then we want to find the min to see what our result at A should be. But this code won't work, as we've seen here. So we want to rewrite it like result at A is equal to the min between our current result, because maybe we already found the min, or result of A minus coin plus 1. The time complexity for this algorithm would be O of amount times coins. The reason for that is because we have to iterate through every single amount, and we also have to iterate through every coins every time we iterate through an amount. And then for space, we just have O of amount because we only need to store each amount in an array. Now that we're done with that, let's get into the code. To start, we just want to initialize our amounts array. And we want to initialize every value in the array to be in positive infinity. The reason is because when we're going to compare our mins later on, we want to have a really big number so that way it doesn't register the first iteration as the min, because otherwise it would be 0. And we're going to do this for a length of amount plus 1. And from here, we just want to set up our base case. So amounts array at 0 is going to be equal to 0 because there are no coins for that. And now we just want to iterate through every amount. So for current amount in range of 1 to amount plus 1. The reason we're doing amount plus 1 is because range is not inclusive. We want to iterate through every coin. So for coin in coins, we want to check if the coin is valid. And to do that, we do current amount minus our current coin. And we check if that's greater than or equal to 0. If it is, then that means the coin is valid. And then from here, we just want to set our min. So amounts array at our current iteration, which would be current amount, is going to be equal to the min between our current index, or is going to be amounts array at our current index minus coin plus 1, like we explained in the pseudocode. And then from here, that's pretty much the whole algorithm. And we could just return amount array at amount. But the problem with that is if we didn't find our actual amount, then this would return an infinity, which is wrong. So we only want to return this in the case that amounts array at amount is not equal to infinity. Otherwise, we want to return negative 1. And that should work. And actually, this is supposed to be in parentheses, and now it should work. So as you can see, this code is pretty efficient. And now we'll go through the code manually. To start, we're going to initialize our amounts array to be equal to infinity at all spots with a size of amount plus 1 to include a space for the 0. After that, we want to initialize our base case, which is index 0, and we want to set it equal to 0. And then now we want to loop from 1 all the way to amounts. So to start, our current amount is going to be equal to 1. And then now we want to iterate through each coin. Our coins are only 1 and 3, and we're going to start with 1. So amounts array at 1 is going to be set to the min between the current value and the current amount minus coin index, which would be equal to 0. After that, we just want to add 1 to it. So the min between infinity and 1 would be 1. And then we can see that this 3 is not a valid coin because 1 minus 3 would be negative, so we're not going to consider that one. And now we go to the next iteration. So current amount is equal to 2. And now we check. If the current amount is less than a current coin, which we're looking at 1 again, so our current amount is 2 minus coin, which is 1, that is greater than 0. So now we want to set array at 2 equal to the min between the current value and current amount minus coin index. So current amount is 2 and the coin is 1, so we want to see the first index and then add 1 to that. And the min between infinity and 2 would be 2. And now we check if 3 is a valid coin. Well, if we check current amount minus coin, we see that 2 minus 3 is negative, so we're not going to consider that either. And now we go to our last iteration. So current amount is now equal to 3. And then for each coin, we're starting at 1 again. Then we want to check current amount minus coin, so 3 minus 1, that is greater than 0. And then now we want to set our array at our current amount, 3, equal to the min between the current value and current amount minus coin index, plus 1. And so we see that 3 minus 1 gives us the index 2, and if we add 1 to that, we get 3. And the min between infinity and 3 is going to be 3. And now we go to our last coin value, 3. And now we check. Current amount, which is 3, minus coin, which is 3, is equal to 0, so that's a valid coin. And now we set our array at the third index equal to the min between the current value and the index at 3 minus 3, which is 0, plus 1. So our index at 0 is 0, and if we add 1 to that, we get 1. The min between 3 and 1 is 1, so we're going to set this to 1. And that's all the coins and the amounts we have to go through. So now we check, is amounts array at amount not equal to infinity? And we see that at 3 it's equal to 1, so that's not true. So we do return this, which is amounts at amount, which would be 1. And that's the right answer. If this video helped you in any way, please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.